Hello everyone, this is Dan from Screaming Frog and this is the Screaming Frog SEO Spider. It's an application that you can download and use on Windows, Mac or Linux machines, and it crawls websites and it analyzes them from an SEO perspective for common SEO issues. Now, it is a free tool that you can download and use for crawling up to 500 URLs. If you'd like to crawl more than that and have access to advanced features such as custom extraction or JavaScript rendering, or save crawls or compare crawls, then you can buy an annual license for £149. And you can see straight away the types of data that's being pulled in here in this master window. I'm just crawling the Screaming Frog website. And if you scroll over to the right, you can see that we have URLs, content types, status codes, indexability, whether the URL is indexable or non-indexable, page titles, meta descriptions, things like headings, H1s, H2s, meta robots, canonicals, pagination, word count, crawl depth, inlinks, outlinks, and lots of different data points for each individual URL in the crawl. And this updates in real time, and you can see in this right-hand overview tab that the data is being updated in real time as well here, and you can scroll up and down. Now, this data here matches the tabs and filters that we have here. So each tab at the top has a filter for either a type or an issue. So for the internal tab, you can see there's various filters here. So I can have a look at any HTML URLs in the crawl or images, for example. But I can also get to it from here as well. I can just click these various filters directly from this right-hand window. And at the bottom, you can see the average and current number of URLs being crawled per second. And over on the right, the number completed and remaining to go to give you an idea of how far you are through the crawl, as well as this progress bar here that updates in real time. Now, if I click on the URL in this top window, this lower window populates, and you can view things like inlinks, outlinks, images on the page, and you can click on the various images there to get a preview. You can also view a SERP snippet preview of the page as well, and there's various other tabs here that you can explore with more data. And to give you an idea, I'll just click through some of these tabs. So you can view any external URLs that are found in the crawl, and you can click on a URL and view the inlinks to see what page it's linked from. If there's any security issues, whether there's any insecure URLs, or whether any URLs have any mixed content issues, and so on and so forth. You can view response code, so things like broken links. You can go and see that, for example, this page here is a 404, and then you can have a look at the inlinks to that page. So perhaps we want to go and update that on the configuration page. You can have a look for any URL issues, any common issues around page titles. So there's any opportunities there to update any duplicate page titles or particularly long or short page titles. And the same for meta descriptions or headings. There's various content issues that can be found, such as exact or near duplicates, low content pages, if any URLs have spelling or grammar errors that you can find. Common issues around images as well, so any particularly large images or any images that are missing alt text or alt attributes completely. Common issues around canonicals. Do pages actually have a canonical? Are they missing? Are they self-referencing or are they canonicalized to another page? Are there multiple on the page? Are any of them non-indexable? And it will help me find errors around those, as well as looking at things like directives. So are any pages no index or anything along those lines? If you have an international setup, you can look at common issues around hreflang as well. We don't. Ajax, AMP, structured data, sitemaps, page speed. You can also search for anything in the source code or extract anything you want using custom extraction. You can also integrate with Google Analytics to pull in session and user data. You can also put in data from Search Console as well or link metrics. And you can see the various APIs here in this right-hand window pane as well. You can obviously export all this data as you see fit using the various export options here. Or bulk export options up here. There's lots of different configuration options that you can go through and adjust. There's also various other options such as exporting XML sitemaps, or you can visualize data in different ways. There's various different crawl diagrams, for example, that allow you to look at the website in a different light and may provide greater perspective. So there's lots of different bits of information. There's also different modes. So this is in spider mode that allows you to crawl a website, but you can also upload a list of URLs or you can compare crawls. And I'll do that now, actually. I will compare, for example, I can compare this crawl against a previous call from another day. It's called select to compare. And this will then change the mode that you're in. You can select what metrics and elements you'd like to compare as well. Click OK, then simply click the compare button. Wait for the analysis to run, which is generally pretty quick for a website of this size. And then it will pull in data and you can see the change percentage, whether there's any new URLs or any URLs are missing, whether any issues have gone up or down, or whether anything's changed, whether there's any pages have changed in crawl depth, there's none here, or whether any pages have more in links than they did previously, and so on and so forth. So hopefully that gives you a good overview of the tool. If you have any questions, then you can contact us by support and we can help. We hope you like the tool. Thanks.